requesting justice to be served for Rusavita. Her human dignity is violated. Therefore, we are marching to oppose bail to the accused because she remains a threat to Rusavita. Her release, her release will be in conflict with Rusavita's protection of life. The victim was tortured, set ablaze alive, locked in the room while the accused watched her burning. The accused never helped to rescue Rusavita. Therefore, as Namibian citizens, we are entitled to local standing. Enough is enough. We do not want the accused to get bail, as she remains a threat to the victim, as well as the community.
And this petition will be used as evidence with regards to it, and it will be used during the bail application and handed up to court for the court to make an informed decision in deciding whether to grant bail or not to the accused.
According to a family member to the victim, the suspect threatened albinos and accused her of having slept with her husband while she was staying in her house, claiming that she has it all on camera.
On Monday, when Dilipo went to work at the office, she started threatening Rose that, you know what, I'm watching a video of whereby you are recorded by cameras and you were cheating. The video shows like you have been cheating on me with my husband. And then Rose was, no, I have never done something like that. How do you dare say something like that to me? I have never done it. And then she keeps on threatening Rusavita. And then Dilipo asked the husband, did you sleep with Rusavita? The husband said, no, I didn't, but I proposed her. But I didn't sleep with her. Then my cousin started picking her things out of the house and move out of the house.
Rusavita's cousin, Julia Marcus, further gave clarity on the relation with the suspect and exactly what transpired between the two women.
The threats keeps on coming in. She keeps on threatening her. And then Rusavita moved to Rehoboth. That's where she called her to come to Windhoek, Dilipo and the husband, to come resolve the issue peacefully with no threats. I encouraged her not to go there alone, but she actually just went there alone. That's when they banned her. She locked her in the room, she poured spirit on her, and then set her on fire. After a few minutes, I was caught when I was at work, go to the hospital, rush to the hospital. Rusavita is in the hospital. That's when I started rushing to the police officer, to the police station, and report the incident.
This is very inhuman. What Dilipo did is not what we were expecting. How can you set someone on fire alive? Dilipo destroyed Rose's life. Rose's life is never going to be the same. If us human cannot respect other women, how will gender-based violence end? We are the gateway to men. Men see from other women to hate other women. So what Dilipo did, Dilipo does not deserve to be in society. Dilipo is a threat to other women. How many women is she going to ban because they slept with her husband? If Dilipo have evidence, she must provide, but what she did is very inhuman. Even if she had evidence, she was not supposed to set her on fire.
My mom told me my sister was called to go stay with her kids in the house while she was traveling with work. And then when she came back, she was demanding, like, my sister come and slept with her husband. And then my sister, she started on Monday, like, beating my sister. On Saturday, they called my sister, like, come to Windhoek, because she was at Rehoboth, come to Windhoek so that we can make peace. The story I heard, it's not true. It's so when my sister came, she locked my sister in the room, pour methylated spirit on her and put on fire.
The victim is currently in a stable condition and recovering well.